Another showdown for pole position between Quartararo and Bagnaia. He's certainly not lacking support here, Fabio Quartararo. Likewise, Johann Zarco. We haven't mentioned Zarco too much in this session. We should check on him. Of course, he has taken a pole position previously here before in Le Mans, and he knows what it takes to get on the podium as well around this Bugatti circuit, the 31-year-old Frenchman. He was second in 2017. That was his first ever MotoGP podium finish. Now then, the Ducati Lenovo team pairing of Bagnaia and Miller wind up to top gear, attacking then on their second soft rear tyre. And at the moment, I think Bagnaia's going to be pretty happy with second. Of course, he'll be hoping for another Tissot watch and another pole position, but front row will be good enough for him. It's a long, long charge up towards that first corner. We've seen how good the Ducati gets off the line so far this year. So that could be crucial for him to get maybe ahead of Fabio Quartararo early on.
The layout of this track as you join it from pit lane makes it not really possible, Matt, to join in and chase someone that's already on a flyer, because you're joining the middle of the chicane. You have to safely get everyone through, and you've got no speed, no temperature. So I think Mark has not managed. I think something going on mechanic-wise, fitting the wheels, has not let him get away in time to follow someone.
Is he going to be resigned then to a place on that fourth row, down in 10th place right now? He would be alongside his Repsol Honda teammate, Pol Espargaró. At the moment, it would be an all-Honda fourth row with Marquez, Pol Espargaró and Nakagami. Here are the two factory Ducatis then.
And the confidence of Fabio just being able to do it by himself. He's out there again alone.
Yeah, nothing seems to fluster Fabio Quartararo, does it? He's always been, well, certainly over the last 18 months or so, been able to handle the pressure. He was a bit, he always used to blow a bit temperamental, a bit hot and cold when things didn't go his way, but he worked so, so hard before 2021 to sort of iron out some of those deficiencies. He did a great job on that, because he's a much calmer, more relaxed rider, isn't he, Fabio Quartararo? Much more on an even keel when things don't go his way. He's able to deal with the setbacks better. Johann Zarco then. The French fans will be loving this, because we now have two Frenchmen on the front row of the grid. Zarco winding up for a pole attack here now. He goes third with a 1:31.037.
And Bastianini's on his way, as you can see.
Yeah, no, now Bastianini. Well, he's had a front row start so far this season, second on the grid. He was in the opening round in Qatar, but he's never had a MotoGP pole position. He's had 9 career poles, but never one in the Premier class. He's using Alex Rins here as a very, very good reference just ahead of him. Not a bad man to follow around this 4.1 kilometre Bugatti circuit, is the Alex Rins on the factory Suzuki. So then, Bastianini, the beast, charges towards the start-finish line here in Le Mans. Is he going on the front row? He certainly is. A 1:37.11. It's so, so close between the front row men. Quartararo, Bagnaia and Bastianini now, a split by just 0.02 of a second. Rins gets himself up into fourth place. His teammate Joan Mir's further down in ninth spot. Oh, look at these lap times coming in here, though, by Bagnaia and Miller. Jack Miller here may well be smashing the all-time lap record and taking pole position here away from his great mate Fabio Quartararo with the help of his teammate Pecco Bagnaia. Oh no, not quite. It was so, so close, but we do have a new all-time lap record broken yet again here in Le Mans. Pecco Bagnaia does it with a 1:30.450. It's a factory Ducati 1-2 right now, with Jack Miller in second place. Quartararo pushed back down to third spot. Bastianini fourth, Zarco fifth, and Rins sixth.
A Ducati 1-2-4-5. A 1-2. Yeah, 1-2-4-5. 1-2-3. Oh, excuse me. 1-2-4-5.
Yeah, and Aleix Espargaró just gets himself up into fifth place with a 1:30.839. An improvement there for Marc Márquez on his sixth lap. Gets down to a 1:31.148, but still not able to move himself any higher up than 10th place. So a fourth row start beckons for the 8-times world champion. Now then, Fabio Quartararo is going to get over the line here for one more lap. It will be this crucial lap, now or never then, if Fabio Quartararo wants to make it a hat-trick of pole positions in MotoGP here in Le Mans. He's going to get a massive roar, a massive cheer and a push from the home crowd here, who are watching to see if Fabio Quartararo can take pole position. Aleix Espargaró on the factory Aprilia, our pole man, of course, in round 3 at Termas Rio Hondo in Argentina. He's putting up another great late fight here for pole on that RSGP machine. Aleix Espargaró, second in the World Championship. Three podium finishes in the last four Grand Prix. More podiums in the last month for Aleix Espargaró than he managed in the previous 16 years. Heady times indeed for the Spanish rider and Aprilia. It's all A-OK now for Aleix Espargaró as he attacks now the start of this fourth sector. Just turns 13 and 14 left for the number 41 on the Aprilia machine. Aleix Espargaró at the moment on course for pole position, but look at this, Quartararo and Bastianini on the charge as well. The checkered flag is out, will track Aleix Espargaró over the line. He goes up into third with a 1:36.09. Will that be good enough for a third successive front row for Aleix Espargaró? Here comes the late charge, and as we knew it would come from Fabio Quartararo. Look at that time, though, he's lost in the third sector. Fabio Quartararo needs to have the inch-perfect fourth sector, the fourth sector of his life here, if he is to take home pole. At the moment, it's Pecco Bagnaia with that 1:34.50, which is keeping the Italian on the factory Ducati in P1. Here comes Quartararo then, over the line, now he comes. He's not even on the front row. Well, that's a big shock. That is a big, big surprise here in France then, because Fabio Quartararo has missed out on a place on the front row. We thought he was going to be a big, big contender for pole position. It didn't work out, and Fabio Quartararo is not going to start his home Grand Prix on the front row. Congratulations then to Ducati's Pecco Bagnaia. Back-to-back poles for him with a new all-time lap record, a sensational 1:30.450. Bagnaia back in business, he certainly is. That's the second successive pole for him. Can he make it back-to-back wins? We said, didn't we, once he got rolling into his winning form in 2021, he was unstoppable. Jack Binner, his teammate, makes it a Ducati Lenovo team 1-2, and another great job. That's the third successive race then for Aleix Espargaró to start in third place.